In this presentation, we are going to discuss on loop control instructions. So in the introduction part, let us understand the importance of loop control instruction. So you may encounter situations when a block of code needs to be executed several number of times. In general, statements are executed sequentially. That is, the first statement in a function is executed first, then followed by the second, and so on. So in programming languages, we provide various control structure that allow for more complicated execution paths. A loop statement allows us to execute a set of statement or a group of statements multiple times. So given below is the general form of a loop statement used in most of the programming languages. C programming has three types of loops: the while loop, the do while loop, and the for loop. So let us discuss each of these loops in detail. So before we start working on loops, let us understand what are loops and the types of loops. So a loop executes the sequence of statements many times until the stated condition becomes false. A loop consists of two parts: a body of a loop and a control statement. The control statement is a combination of some conditions that direct the body of the loop to execute until the specified condition becomes false. The purpose of the loop is to repeat the same code a number of times. So here, by loop, we mean that there will be a sequence of instructions that will be repeated until the specified condition becomes false. So when we want certain set of instructions to perform certain operation repeatedly, we put such instruction into a loop. So these instruction keep on executing until the condition which has been specified becomes false. So there are different types of loops. Depending upon the position of a control statement in a program, a loop is classified into two types. The first one is the entry control loop, and the second one is the exit controlled loop. So what is an entry controlled loop? So in an entry control loop, a condition is checked before executing the body of a loop. It is also called as a pre-checking loop. So in this entry control loop, we mean that the instructions written inside the loop will be executed only if the condition is satisfied. Once the condition is satisfied, then only the statement inside the loop gets executed. So you call it as an entry control loop. In an exit control loop, a condition is checked after executing the body of a loop. It is also called as a post checking loop. So in this exit control loop, the statements that are to be executed are written first, and the condition to be verified is written later. So initially, at least once, the statement written inside the loop gets executed first, and then the condition is checked. If the condition is satisfied, then the statement inside the loop keep on executing. So whenever the condition is to be checked first and then the statement to be executed, such loop is called as entry control loop. Whereas in an exit control loop, the condition is checked after executing the body of the loop. Some of the important points that need to be remembered when we work on loops. So the control conditions must be well defined and specified. Otherwise, the loop will execute an infinite number of times. So if we do not specify the conditions correctly, the statement written inside the loop keep on executing infinitely. The loop that does not stop executing and processes the statements number of times is called as an infinite loop. An infinite loop is also called as an endless loop. So following are some of the characteristics of an infinite loop. First one is, no termination condition is specified. Second one is, the specified conditions never meet. The specified condition determines whether to execute the loop body or not. So when there is no termination condition specified, then the statement inside the loop keep on executing, and such loop is called as an infinite loop. So while writing a program using loop, we need to take care of the control conditions that we specify. So we have a sample for loop diagram which specifies how the looping system works. So once the condition is true, we can see that the block of code written inside the loop gets executed and it keeps on repeating. First time the condition is checked. If the condition is true, it executes the block of code written inside that particular loop. Once the set of instruction gets executed, then once again the condition is checked. If the condition still holds true, once again the set of statement written inside the block gets executed, and this keeps on repeating unless and until the condition is false. Once the condition is false, we come out of the loop and execute those statements which are written outside the loop. So this is how in C programming, as we know, we have three types of loops: the while loop, the do while loop, and the for loop. So let us understand the first loop, that is the while loop. So a while loop in C programming repeatedly executes a target statement as long as a given condition is true. So the statement written inside the while loop keeps on repeatedly executing as long as the condition is true. Once the condition becomes false, we come out of the while loop. The syntax of a while loop is: we have a keyword while, in parentheses we specify the condition, and inside the while loop we have set of executable statements which will be repeated till the condition which we have specified becomes false. So let us understand how the while loop works. So it is an entry controlled loop. As we can see from the syntax of while loop, that the condition is checked first before the set of instruction written inside the loop gets executed. So we call while loop as an entry controlled loop. So in while loop, a condition is evaluated before processing a body of the loop. So here the condition is evaluated first. If the condition is true, then and only then the body of a loop is executed. So if we want the statement inside the body of the loop to be executed, then the condition has to be satisfied first. After the body of a loop is executed, then the control again goes back to the beginning, and the condition is checked. If it is true, the same process is executed until the condition becomes false. So here the statement written inside the body of the loop keep on executing till the condition is satisfied. Once the condition returns false, then the loop stop executing the statements. So once the condition become false, the control goes out of the loop. After exiting the loop, the control goes to the statements which are immediately after the loop. So the body of a loop can contain more than one statement. If it contains only one statement, then the curly braces are not compulsory. But it is a good practice, though, to use the curly braces even we have a single statement in the body. So in the while loop, if the condition is not true, then the body of the loop will not be executed, not even once. So let us demonstrate the working of while loop using a C program. So we have a program which prints a series of numbers from 1 to 10 using while loop. So we are going to print the numbers from 1 to 10 in series. So let us see how the while loop works. So inside a main function, we have declared a variable num of type integer and initialized a value 1 to 8. So the variable num has a value 1 assigned. The next instruction that we have is the while loop instruction, where we have specified a condition where num is less than or equal to 10. So the condition return in the while statement is while num is less than or equal to 10. And there are two set of instructions written inside the body of the loop. One is the printf statement, which is going to print the value that is stored in num. And the second instruction that we have is the num value is getting incremented. So num plus plus will increment the value that is stored in the variable num by 1. So let us understand how the program works. So as we have initialized the variable num as 1, a while loop first checks for the condition. So as num variable is assigned as 1, so 1 is less than or equal to 10. So as 1 is less than or equal to 10, the condition is satisfied here, and we enter inside the while loop. So in this, the first statement that comes into execution is the printf. It prints the value of num. The value of num is 1. So on the output screen we find the value of num getting printed. We print it as 1. Then the num variable gets incremented by 1. Now the value stored inside the num is incremented from 1 to 2. So plus plus increments the value by 1. So the curly braces tells that the statements are inside the loop. So once again we go to the initial condition where once again the condition is checked. Now the value of num is 2, so 2 is less than 10. Now the condition is still satisfying. The condition sets to true. We again enter the while loop. We print the value that is stored in num. This time it will be 2, and then the variable num gets incremented by 1. Now the value stored inside the num becomes 3. Once again we go back to the condition. The num value is now incremented to 3. As 3 is less than 10, once again we enter inside the loop. We print the value 3 and the variable num gets incremented by 1. After this, once again we move on to the initial condition. Now the num value becomes 4, and as 4 is less than 10, the condition is true and we enter inside the loop once again. So here we can see that unless and until the condition is satisfied, we keep on repeating a set of statements again and again. So these statements keeps on repeating till we reach certain condition which returns a false. Now assume that the variable num has reached a value 10. So num has a value 10. Now 10 is less than or equal to 10. So 10 is not less than 10, but it is equal to 10. So condition gets satisfied. We come inside the loop. We print the value of num as 10. So num plus plus will increment the value stored in num. This time it will be 11. So now we move on to the initial condition. So num value has incremented to 11. So 11 is not less than 10, neither 11 is equal to 10. So here the condition becomes false, and then we come out of the loop. This is how the while loop works. In the program, we have seen that we have initialized num to 1. So when num is 1, the test expression num less than or equal to 10 is true, as the value of num is 1. As the body of the while loop is executed, this prints 1 on the screen and the value of num is increased to 2. Now num is 2, the test expression num less than or equal to 10 is again true, as the value of num 2 is less than 10, it satisfies. The body of the while loop is executed again, and this prints 2 on the screen, and the value of num is increased to 3. So this process goes on until num becomes 11. So when num is 11, the test expression num, that is 11 less than or equal to 10, will be false, as 11 is not less than 10, or neither it is equal to 10, and the loop terminates. So this is how the while loop works.